Hello guys, it's Deepshaw over here and today I'm going to show you how to create this creative face manipulation effect in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool effects using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So I'm going to create this face manipulation effect using three different face images. Now it's up to you if you want to use a single face image or different face images like me. So now this is the first face image which I'm going to use over here. So the first step over here is we need to select the portion of the face which we want to keep using pen tool. So for that, select pen tool and then using pen tool select that portion of the face which you want to keep. Now I'm zooming into the image for proper selection. So now once the path has been created, after that right click inside of the path and then select option make selection. After that click on OK. Now once the selection is there, after that press Ctrl plus J to create a duplicate of the selection into a new layer. After that hide the background layer. Now I want this face in black and white mode instead of color, so for that click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option black and white over there. After that you can set the red, yellows, green, cyans and blue accordingly. So now this looks proper. After that right click on the black and white layer and then select option create clipping mask. Now we need to make this face look like a hollow face, so for that make the background layer active by clicking on it and then create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. After that using pen tool try to make a circular path as follows. So once the path look proper, after that we need to fill this path with that of black color, so for that right click inside of the path and then select option fill. After that select use as black color and then click on OK. So as you can see, the path has been filled with that of black color. After that press the delete key of your keyboard to remove the path. Now after deleting the path, if you feel that the circular portion is not looking proper, then you can press Ctrl plus T and then right click over there and then select option warp. After that you can play with different points to make it look more proper. Now once it looks proper, after that click on the stick icon to place it. After that using move tool you can place it properly as well. Now this looks proper, so after that we need to fill the inside portion of the face with that of lighter color to make it look more realistic. So for that create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then select brush tool and brush as soft round. After that set the foreground color as any lighter gray color. After that press Ctrl and click on the icon of the black layer which will give you the selection of that layer. And now using brush tool hover as follows. After that press Ctrl plus D to deselect the selection. After that reduce the opacity of the gray layer to 50%. So now as you can see this is looking proper. Now to avoid any confusion I'm renaming all the layers. So let's rename this layer as face 1 gray layer. After that rename the layer below it as face 1 black layer and then rename the second layer as face layer and then rename the top layer as face 1 black and white layer. Now we need to create a bevel and emboss kind of thing to the edges of the hollow gap over here to make it look more realistic. So for that make the face 1 gray layer active by clicking on it. After that create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then select pen tool and then using pen tool make a path as follows. Now once the path is ready, after that right click inside of the path and then select option fill path. After that set the color as any light gray color. And then click on OK. After that click on OK. After that press the delete key of your keyboard to delete that path. Now if you feel that the edge is not looking proper, then press Ctrl plus T and then right click over there and then select option warp. Now you can set the points accordingly so that it looks proper. Now once it looks proper, after that click on the stick icon to place it. Now we need to do the same thing for the other part of the hollow edge, so for that make the background layer active by clicking on it. And then create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. After that using pen tool make a selection as follows. Now once the path is ready, after that right click inside of the path and then select option make selection. And then click on OK. After that set the foreground color as the same color which you had set for the bottom edge. After that select paint bucket tool and then using paint bucket tool fill the selection as follows. After that press Ctrl plus D to deselect that selection. Now we have the face 1 image ready over here. Now we need to do the same thing for the face 2 model image. So for that drag the face 2 model image into a new document. Now over here we will be following the same steps as we followed for the face 1 image. So for that using pen tool make the selection of the face image you want to keep. After that right click inside of the path and then select option make selection. After that press Ctrl plus J to create a duplicate of the selection. Now hide the background layer by clicking on the eye icon. After that rename that layer as face 2. After that convert this face image into a black and white image. After that make the background layer active by clicking on it. After that create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. And then using pen tool make a selection as follows. After that right click inside of the path and then select option fill path. Then select use as black and then click on OK. After that press the delete key of your keyboard to delete the path. After that you can scale and place it accordingly. After that rename that layer as face to black. After that again create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. After that press Ctrl and click on the icon of the black layer. After that select any foreground color as light gray color. After that select brush tool. Brush as soft round. And then using brush tool hover as follows. After that press Ctrl plus D to deselect the selection. Now reduce the opacity of the gray layer to 50%. After that rename that layer as face to gray. Now we need to create the border for the edges, so for that follow the same step as followed in phase 1. So now as you can see our phase 2 is also ready, now rename the two layers as phase 2 border. Now we need to take this face image into that of first face image, so for that make the top layer active by clicking on it. And then press shift and click on the bottom face layer which will give you the selection of the two layers as well as give you the selection of all layers in between. After that press Ctrl plus G to merge all the layers into a single group. After that select move tool and then using move tool drag the face image into that of first face document. Now place this group above face 1 gray layer. After that press Ctrl plus T and then scale the group accordingly. Now this looks perfect, after that click on the stick icon to place it. Now we need to add shadows to the phase 2 to make it look like as if phase 2 is placed inside that of phase 1. So for that create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. And then select brush tool. brush as soft round, and then select foreground color as black. You can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. Now using the brush, hover over the edges of the face one as follows. After that, reduce the opacity of the layer to 60%. And then rename that layer as shadow on face 2. Now after that, we need to do the same thing for the third face image layer, just that we won't be converting it into a black and white image. So now as you can see, we have created the face 3 and dragged it over here as well. Now we need to place the face 3 group layer above the face 2 gray layer over here. So for that, expand the group of the face 2 and then drag the group of the face 3 above the face 2 gray layer. After that, press Ctrl plus T and then scale it accordingly. Press Shift while scaling to scale evenly. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now we need to add shadow over here as well, so for that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then select brush tool and set the foreground color as black. And then using brush tool, do it as follows. After that, reduce the opacity of the layer to 50%. So now that looks proper, so now minimize the group to layer. And now we need to add background and crop this image over here. So for that, make the background layer active by clicking on it and then select crop tool and then crop the image as follows. So now that looks proper. After that, we need to place all the faces at the center of the document. So for that, select the bottom face layer and then select and then press shift and then select the top face layer. After that, select move tool and then using move tool, place it at the center of the document. So now that looks proper. After that, we need to create a background for this document. So for that, make the background layer active by clicking on it and then click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option gradient over there. After that, set the gradient as black and white. Set the style as radial. Scale it to 300% and then click on this reverse checkbox. After that, click on OK. So now that looks proper. After that, we need to add shadow at the bottom of the document. So for that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then select brush tool, foreground color as black, and then using brush tool, click on the document as follows. After that, press Ctrl plus T and then scale it as follows. Now this looks proper. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So now this looks proper. After that, reduce the opacity of the layer to 60%. So that's it guys, this will give you a creative face manipulation effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.